Sawadee kap. Welcome to Phuket Extra, brought to you by PSD Windows and Doors. It's Friday, April 10th, and I'm your host, JP Mestanza. Let's get started. The island-wide lockdown of Phuket will begin this Monday, April 13th, with all people asked to stay in their sub-districts. With the exception of good deliveries and emergency services, all travel within Phuket is being restricted, with the government telling people to not leave their sub-district or local municipality for 14 days, beginning on Monday morning, April 13th, what would have been the first day of Songkran. Officials on the island, they're saying that they will begin door-to-door checks all across the island, all to check on the body temperatures of residents and to identify people infected with the coronavirus. Phuket is the first province to announce such a measure, and it comes after the island received some 3,000 infrared thermometers by the Department of Disaster Prevention, with volunteers and officials set to knock on every household door on the island, according to their announcement. Meanwhile, foreigners stuck in Phuket are being prompted to book into one of five hotels that have been given government permission to remain open and book new guests, while all other hotels on the island are closed down due to the coronavirus pandemic. These hotels include the Dara Hotel near Central Festival Shopping Mall, a hotel called the Throne, and another one called the Tide Beachfront Hotel. Both are on Koh Si Rae, which is just east of Phuket town. The fourth is the Patong Bay Inn in Phuket Sin City, and the fifth is the Nayang Beach Hotel out near the airport. Hotel guests are responsible for their own expenses through their stay period, as specified in the announcement by Phuket provincial officials. For the rest, visit thephuketnews.com. 50 new confirmed coronavirus cases were announced today for Thailand, as the number of infections in Phuket now reaches 170. Thailand now has a total of 2,473 cases nationwide, and out of that, 1,023 people total have been discharged. All the cases are spread out over 68 provinces. One person has died, a 43-year-old Thai man, as the death toll now reaches 33 for the country. Bangkok has the most number of cases with 1,234, followed by 9 cases for Phuket, which is 170 total cases now. The island has the highest rate of infection with a ratio of 38.9 cases per 100,000 people in the population. 42 people in Phuket are still awaiting COVID-19 test results. The Education Ministry says that next year's two school breaks scheduled for October and April next year, they will be scrapped due to the COVID-19 disruption. The new school term was pushed back to July 1st as a containment effort against the virus. But still, officials said that the new adjustments with the school breaks, they will be made as the postponement has a knock-on effect for school terms in the coming years. Here's a brief recap of the current measures in Phuket meant to halt the spread of COVID-19. There's a nationwide nightly curfew at 10 p.m. until 4 a.m. and a soft curfew at 8 p.m. in Phuket. You'll get a warning before 10 p.m. and after that, authorities say they will arrest anyone outside, with some listed exceptions. The Phuket airport is closed until the end of the month. All inbound international commercial flights are already banned, with some exceptions, as repatriation flights from some countries have taken place. All bridges, ports, and piers are closed for non-essentials. All entertainment venues, gyms, shopping malls, public spaces, schools, and major businesses are closed, with the exception of some supermarkets, banks, and pharmacies. All 24-hour convenience shops close at 8 p.m. until 4 a.m. All hotels are closed in Phuket unless they have guests, then they have to wait until they check out, and then the hotel has to close, with some government-designated exceptions. For restaurants, only delivery and takeaways are allowed. There are shutdowns in Patong, Karon, Rawai, Chulalongkorn, Gatu, and Srisutorn, with an island-wide lockdown expected Monday, April 13th for 14 days, and all entry or exit for non-essential vehicles are banned, although enforcement could vary in certain parts. The governor on April 7th ordered the wearing of face masks compulsory in Phuket, with anyone violating the order facing a 20,000 baht fine. Stay up to date with the latest at thephuketnews.com. And that's it for Phuket Extra today, brought to you by PSD Windows and Doors. For safe, secure, and soundproof windows, visit pvcphuket.com. Thank you so much for joining us this week as we bring you the most up-to-date and useful information for you during this pandemic. Thank you so much again for watching, and until Monday, stay classy, Phuket.